the HR 2116, or the Creating a Respectful and Open World for Natural Hair Act, passed in a vote of 235 to 189. So it passed, 189 voted against it. So you might think, oh, really divisive bill, right? Really partisan bill. Well, why? What does it do? It prohibits discrimination, quote, based on the individual's hair texture or hairstyle, if that hair texture or that hairstyle is commonly associated with a particular race or national origin. Among the hairstyles mentioned in the legislation are those in which hair is tightly coiled or tightly curled, locks, cornrows, twist braids, Bantu knots, and afros. That's it. It stops you from being able to be discriminated for having natural hair. That's it. And that is what 189 Republicans voted against in this case. And they didn't just vote against it. They did it in like the way best designed to prove how discriminatory they are, how biased, how bigoted they are. Here's Lauren Boebert.
What purpose does a gentlelady from Colorado seek recognition?
Madam Speaker, as a member designated by Mr. Louie Gohmert, I am for the House, and Mr. Gohmert will vote nay on H.R. 211-16, the bad hair bill.
For what purpose does a gentlelady from New Hampshire?
So it's not just that they voted against it, it's that Lauren Boebert, stay classy, calls it the bad hair bill. Remember, like she's minimizing it there, as others will, we'll get to that. But she's also opposing it. She's acting as if it's a waste of their time, but she also doesn't want it to pass. They are explicitly for people being able to be discriminated against for the hair that grows naturally out of their head.
We affirm, say it loud, black is beautiful and so is our hair. Whether you are a student in a classroom, an employee in the workplace, or the next Supreme Court justice or the Speaker pro tem, you deserve to show up as your full self, rocking your crown with your head held high. I urge a yes vote for every person who has been asked to shrink or to apologize simply for the beautiful way with which God made them.
So Representative Ayanna Pressley with an impassioned plea for the passage of the Crown Act. And we've got good news when it comes to that. Powerful, effective, classy speech there. We have a representative giving the exact opposite.
Purpose does a gentlelady from Colorado seek recognition?
Madam Speaker, as a member designated by Mr. Louie Gohmert, I am for the House, and Mr. Gohmert will vote nay on H.R. 211-16, the bad hair bill.
For what purpose does a gentlelady from New Hampshire?
So it's not just that they voted against it, it's that Lauren Boebert, stay classy, calls it the bad hair bill. Remember, like she's minimizing it there, as others will, we'll get to that. But she's also opposing it. She's acting as if it's a waste of their time, but she also doesn't want it to pass. They are explicitly for people being able to be discriminated against for the hair that grows naturally out of their head, for hairstyles that are in some cases deeply tied to culture, to national origin. This is a terrible practice. For instance, in 2019, a 16-year-old African-American wrestler in New Jersey was ordered by a white referee to cut off his dreadlocks before wrestling, or else he'd have to forfeit. It affects sporting, it affects people's college careers, it gets people fired or not hired in the first place. It is a disgusting practice of discrimination that goes back as long as America has been a country and before, and 189 Republicans in 2022 still opposed it. Lauren Boebert is unfortunately back in the news, this time for apparently asking a group of Orthodox Jews at the Capitol if they were conducting reconnaissance. They did not like this. Their host, Representative Tom Suozzi, who was hosting the group there at the Capitol, didn't like this. They were at the Capitol to commemorate the 41st anniversary of the end of the Iran hostage crisis. They've apparently, the group of Orthodox Jews that were there have been backing the representative's plan to recognize the hostages with a congressional gold medal when they unfortunately ran into Lauren Boebert. Near an elevator, by the way, if you're gonna run into her at the Capitol, don't be near an elevator. The worst things happen there. One witness said that the group, along with other members of Congress, was waiting for that elevator. When the doors opened, Boebert stepped out and looked at the group of visitors from head to toe. Boebert then asked if they were there to conduct reconnaissance. A rabbi who was there says, when I heard that, I actually turned to the person standing next to me and asked, did you just hear that? You know, I'm not sure to be offended or not. I was very confused.
I thought that Lauren Boebert, like most Republicans, loved Jews, loved, supported Israel, but then to call Israelis essentially terrorists or Jews is purport, you know, assuming they're Israelis, essentially looking for doing reconnaissance for some kind of terrorist plot. Lauren Boebert seems to be one of God knows how many hidden Republicans actually secretly hate Jews and are turning on them. I think if the Republican Party apparatus had any amount of decency, honor, and consistency, they would target Lauren Boebert and on behalf of Israel, oust them from the party and any participation they might have in anything remotely, tangibly close to lawmaking or dollar appropriation. And as Congress has the power of the purse in America for Israel's sake, they must throw her out of her seat in Congress.